Before the break, I had the opportunity to sit down with the Burpo family, the subjects of a new major motion picture, Heaven is for Real. And joining me now is the movie's director, Randall Wallace. Randall, welcome to the show.
Oh, so great to be with
you. Great to be with you. Now, you read the book, and then did you just decide this has to be a movie? How did this happen?
Well, I read the book, and I really fell in love with the Burpo family. I saw such a real story in them, people who weren't trying to manufacture something, but someone for whom a miracle had happened, a completely real kind of miracle. You know, what happens when you're a parent and you go through this experience of nearly losing your child, an unthinkable thing to me. And then he starts to talk about what heaven is like. It's like everything you would want to believe, and then can you really accept that? And what are its implications? It's not like they thought, how do we manufacture a story? It's like suddenly we're in the grip of God. And that's a great tale anytime, anywhere.
Well, was that a challenge? How do you depict heaven? I mean, even as a very great movie maker as you are, I mean, how do you depict something that nobody has really seen?
That was the big scary part. Because in most movies, what you end up with is like, Morgan Freeman in white pajamas and and everything, and which I love the movie in which that
Bruce
appeared.
Bruce Almighty, yeah.
I love that movie. It's made by a great friend of mine. And I understand why you do that, because heaven is so majestic. There's always been a prohibition against trying to depict the face of God out of the sacredness, and it's too holy. But this boy, Colton Burpo, came back saying, this is what heaven is like. And that was what was so gripping to me. And I wanted to let the audience see that, experience that. And the closest that I knew how to come was inspired by the Lord's Prayer, on earth as it is in heaven. And the thought that, as C.S. Lewis said, God is a great artist. And God's handiwork is evident to us here in this world at its most beautiful, at its unspoiled. So we didn't try to create fantasy elements for heaven. We tried to use the most beautiful elements of the earth to say, this must be what heaven is like.
Right. Well, there have been some early screenings, and I fortunately had the opportunity to see it. What are some of the reactions that you're getting from people?
Well, did it ruin your mascara? Because it's making a lot of people emotional.
It did, actually. There's some very emotional scenes.
And it is for me, too. In screenings now, and I've seen the movie, you know, dozens and dozens of times, and it still moves me. What has really been striking to me is that people of faith, people who see themselves as having a spiritual discipline and practicing, they really love this movie. What surprised me, but is something that we all wanted, I know the Burpos wanted it and I sure wanted it too, is that the movie would say to people who see themselves as outside the faith, that God loves them, that God is always reaching out. And that the audiences that have come in, we tested it for audiences who identified themselves as having no faith at all. And their emotional reaction has been as great as the faith-based audience. They're less likely to want to talk about it because they're afraid of sounding religious. But they love the movie, and it's a movie that reaches across boundaries. I love to say God's love jumps all the fences.
It sure does. Great. Well said. Well, you got Greg Kinnear, one of my favorite actors, to play Todd Burpo, and it is an all-star cast. Was that difficult? Because this is a faith-based movie, and Hollywood can sometimes have some issues with that. Did the actors, did Kinnear and the others have any problem knowing this is a very evangelical, faith-based movie?
I'll tell you, writing, directing, acting, what we're doing, what you do, it's an act of faith. You've got to have the courage to face whatever somebody, and if you live your life along the lines of, I'm going to let myself be measured by what other people think of me, then you've lost your soul. And in some ways, the fundamental spiritual issue is to say, God loves me, that's enough. If God loves me, then nothing else will matter, because everything else will be right. And those actors that I asked, all of the actors that I wanted said yes immediately.
Wow.
And I can only attribute that to something much greater than me working.
Well, you have written, produced, and directed some of Hollywood's biggest hits, Braveheart, probably everyone's favorite movie. I know it's one of my favorite movies. How have you seen God use you in the secular world of movie making?
I think the biggest thing for me is that God's plans are way greater than our plans are. One of my early teachers in the seminary said, if you want to make God laugh, just tell God your plans. I didn't go to Hollywood planning to be a director at all. It was never my ambition.
Really? Why'd you go? To be an actor?
I wanted to be a songwriter.
Oh.
And I was so good at it that no one ever listened to my songs. No one ever wanted to hear me sing.
But then you end up making Braveheart, working with Mel Gibson, and Pearl Harbor, and the list goes on. And what do you hope, Randall, what do you hope people are going to take away from Heaven is for Real?
I want people to have the experience in the movie of having had a glimpse of heaven themselves. Mm. And when they go, they'll have a sense of joy and wonder and a sense of mystery. But, you know, so much that we talk about when you have a crisis of faith, when we say that,
right,
it generally means that something terrible has happened to you.
Right.
But in fact, the real challenge is to believe the best possible things are true.
Wow.
That God loves you, that where babies come from is where we go when we take our last breaths here.
Mm.
If we can believe that, then life is eternal and eternally wonderful.
That is profound, and I seriously wish we had more time. Randall Wallace, thanks so much for spending some time with us today. We appreciate it.
Thank you so much.
The movie Heaven is for Real opens on April 16th in theaters nationwide, and a special movie edition of the book is available nationwide. Coming up, Gordon will be back with more 700 Club Interactive right after this.